All right, so today we're tackling something that I think everyone listening can relate to, right? Cold calling. It's like that that necessary evil of the sales world.
Yeah.
And to help us navigate this, we're diving deep into Claude Diamond and his G.U.T.S. sales training.
Yes.
Giving you ultimate telephone skills, right?
Got it.
And judging by the YouTube excerpts you sent over, this Diamond guy, he really lives up to that name. Like, he is all about that phone.
He seems to really emphasize that direct approach.
Yeah, it's like nonstop. Call me. Here's my number again. Visit my website, which, by the way, is also plastered everywhere.
Well, it's interesting, though, right? Because in today's world, with all the email and social media and everything, it's almost like the phone has become, well, a little scary for some people.
Especially in sales. I mean, think about it.
You're reaching out to someone cold. They don't know you. They're not necessarily expecting your call.
Or interrupting their day.
Exactly. And that's what's so interesting about Diamond's approach, because he seems to acknowledge that fear. He actually calls it out. That's why he calls his method G.U.T.S. in the first place, because it takes guts to pick up the phone and make those calls, especially when they're cold.
Okay, so then how does he get people over that fear?
Well, one of the things he talks about is transforming those cold calls into what he calls warm calls.
Warm calls.
Oh.
So you're not ditching the phone altogether?
No, not at all. It's more about changing your mindset and how you approach that initial contact. Like, instead of going in completely cold, he suggests doing a little research beforehand. You know, check out their LinkedIn profile, see if you have any shared connections or interests, maybe mention a recent post they made.
Ah, I see. So you're not just some random caller. You're someone who's already taken an interest in them.
Exactly. It's about finding common ground, something to break the ice and make that initial connection feel less, well, less cold.
Okay, so that makes sense. But then he also does this thing, right? This
reality sales training.
Yes. Reality sales training. Tell us about that.
So this is where things get really interesting. Imagine this. You're learning from Diamond, and part of his training involves actually making live sales calls with clients. Like, he's right there with you.
Whoa, that's intense.
It is, and I think that's the point. He's all about throwing you right into the deep end.
I could see how that would be effective.
Yeah.
But man, talk about nerve-wracking.
Definitely. But by facing your fears head-on with someone there to guide you, it can be incredibly powerful. You're learning by doing, and that's invaluable in sales.
Okay, so we got the warm calls, the reality training, and then there's this whole other layer he adds, which is this idea of pattern interrupts. What exactly is a pattern interrupt?
That's such a cool concept. Have you ever gotten a telemarketing call and actually found yourself listening instead of just hanging up immediately?
Oh, I know what you mean. Like, they say something and you're like, wait, what?
Exactly. That's usually because they've done something to break through your defenses. Instead of launching into the same old script, maybe they start with a joke or ask an unexpected question.
That's something that catches you off guard.
Right. And that's a pattern interrupt. It disrupts your normal thought process, your automatic response, and forces you to pay attention. And Diamond, he's clearly a big believer in using these pattern interrupts in sales.
Although he doesn't really get into specifics in these videos, does he? Like, how do you use them?
He mentions them a lot, but yeah, he's a little vague on the details, kind of like he's hinting at a secret weapon.
So we know he's got these pattern interrupts, but then there's this whole other thing. He talks about this doctor analogy. Like, he gets into this whole psychological thing, right? Mm-hmm. The doctor. So what's this about a doctor?
Well, Diamond, he uses this analogy of a doctor, like a specialist, you know, someone who's in high demand.
Okay, so this is a doctor with a packed schedule.
Right. So let's say you're this patient and you're considering surgery.
And this doctor, they're like the best there is.
Exactly. So Diamond's saying, this doctor, they'll often use their limited availability as a way to, well, kind of nudge the patient towards a decision.
Ah, I see where you're going with this. It's the whole scarcity thing.
Exactly. He gives this example where the doctor mentions a cancellation, you know, like a rare opening for surgery the very next day.
Oh, so you can get in right away. But
if you don't take that slot, you might be looking at a wait until next year.
Oh, wow. Yeah, that would definitely light a fire under me.
Right. It's like this instant psychological pressure.
I don't want to miss out.
Exactly. And that's what he's getting at, this whole idea of loss aversion. It's this psychological principle. We're wired to feel the pain of a loss way more strongly than the pleasure of a gain.
So it's like we're more motivated by fear than reward.
In a nutshell, yeah. And salespeople, they've been using this principle forever. Limited time offers, dwindling supplies, you know the drill.
Oh yeah, those last chance emails always get me.
Exactly. It's all about tapping into that sense of urgency, that fear of missing out. And in the doctor example, that sense of urgency, that scarcity, it's amplified by the fact that it's the doctor's time that's limited.
It makes total sense. Like you said, we're talking about a specialist, someone who's really in demand. Their time is precious. But okay, let's say I'm a salesperson. How do I actually use this principle ethically in my calls? I mean, it's not like I can manufacture a year-long waiting list.
Right. You're not trying to mislead anyone. It's more about framing the value of what you're offering within a context of limited time or availability.
So how do you do that? Give me an example.
Okay. So let's say you're on a call with a potential client. Instead of just saying, hey, are you free to chat tomorrow? You could try something like, you know, I just had a slot open up in my schedule for tomorrow afternoon, which is rare.
So you're subtly implying that your time is valuable, that this opening is a lucky break for them.
Exactly. And then you can follow up with something like, if you're free then, we could dive a little deeper into how I can help you.
Ah, okay. So you're not pressuring them, but you are creating that sense of, hey, this opportunity might not be around forever.
Precisely. It's all about that subtle nudge without being manipulative. And that seems to be a big part of Diamond's G.U.T.S. method overall, wouldn't you say? It's direct, it's persuasive, but it's not about putting undue pressure on people.
No, it's definitely more about building that rapport, that trust. Okay, so we've got these high stakes, reality sales training, the pattern interrupts, which are still a bit of a mystery, and now this whole scarcity angle. Anything else we should know about Diamond's approach before we move on? You know, it strikes me that for all this talk about, like, sales funnels and automation and all that, Diamond's method, it almost feels kind of, I don't know, old school.
It does, doesn't it?
Like, in a good way. It's refreshing, actually.
Yeah.
Like, in a world of, you know, constant digital noise.
Right.
He's all about that human connection.
It's true. Picking up the phone, having a conversation, like a real conversation. It's so rare these days. I mean, think about it. When was the last time you got a genuine personalized phone call from someone, especially someone trying to sell you something?
Oh my gosh, right. It's all spam calls and robots.
Exactly. Yeah. Everyone's so used to getting bombarded with generic emails and automated messages.
Our inboxes are overflowing, but our phones are like ghost towns.
Exactly. And so when you, as a salesperson, you actually take the time to call someone directly and you're not hiding behind a script, you're having a real conversation, that cuts through the noise.
That's like that pattern interrupt we were talking about earlier.
Yes. It's unexpected, it makes you memorable, and in a world that's so saturated, so noisy, that in itself can be a huge advantage.
It makes you stand out.
Absolutely.
So it's not just about phone skills, really, is it? It's bigger than that. It's about, like you said, that human connection. And in a way, bringing that into a world that's becoming, I don't know, less and less human.
I think that's a great way to put it. Diamond's G.U.T.S. method, it's about recognizing the power of authenticity, of genuine connection, in a world that's becoming increasingly disconnected.
And honestly, that's something we could all use a little more of.
Couldn't agree more.
Well, on that note, it makes you wonder, right? In this age where everyone's obsessed with automation and like scaling everything,
right?
Could this kind of high-touch, human-centered approach be like the secret weapon?
That is the question, isn't it? It really makes you think.
It really does. And I bet there are a lot of people listening right now who are thinking the exact same thing. So if you're out there and you've had success with this, whether it's cold calling or finding your own way to connect with clients in this crazy digital world, we want to hear about it. Head over to our website, find us on social media. Let's keep this conversation going. Until next time, happy selling, everybody.